Carma Laboratories. Thank you for joining us, and I'd like to introduce Jelani Eddington and Zach Frame, who will be performing for you this afternoon.
Joining us here today, it's a real pleasure to be able to share with you the sounds of this beautiful theater pipe organ. That very first piece of music that you heard was called Broadway Rhythm, and it was written by Nacio Herb Brown and used in the musical Singin' in the Rain. What I'd like to continue with is a little bit of music that was made famous by the great Judy Garland, a piece of music called Get Happy. This particular arrangement was inspired by one that I heard the late, great Chris Gorsuch play. One of the things about his music that was so compelling and so interesting to me is his great sense of jazz, the great harmonies that he had, and the wonderful rhythm. And hopefully that will come through in this next arrangement of Get Happy. Next up, it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you a young man that I've had the pleasure of knowing over a number of years. He is currently the headlining organist at the Organ Piper Music Palace in Greenfield, Wisconsin, Zach Frank.
Well, thank you, Jelani, and thank you all again for joining us today. I'm going to continue on with a beautiful piece of music composed back in about 1951 by Irving Gordon. Irving was first of all a lyricist and later on went to compose a lot of music, including this tune, which was made famous by the great Nat King Cole. Here's Unforgettable.
Thank you.
Well, switching gears into some movie music next, of course, music by the great John Williams. One of my favorite John Williams movie scores happens to be some music from the 1978 film Superman. We'll hear a couple of pieces from that, of course, the main theme, and then the beautiful ballad, Can You Read My Mind?
Thank you.
large theater pipe organ in our warehouse, and the usual question is, do you play the organ? And I say, well, yes, I play the organ like I play radio. My love of archaic automated musical instruments came through, and Charles Keg restored a Moller Artiste role player from 1930, installing the organ here. And with the help of Steve Hansen, Jelani, Zach, and Charles Keg, you'll be hearing the Moller Artiste 1930 role player playing Finlandia and the Mendelssohn Scherzo from Midsummer Night's Dream.
Thank you.
Here's a fun piece of music that was written by E.T. Paul all the way back in 1900. One of the things that I really enjoy about this piece of music is that it features one of the most unusual sound effects on the organ, the fire bell. Here is the Midnight Fire Alarm.
Once again, some more of my favorite music, this time some music from the big bands, and of course the great Duke Ellington Orchestra. This particular tune was composed by the great Billy Strayhorn back in 1941. Here's their classic hit, Take the A-Train.
Thank you.
once again some music highly influenced by the great Chris Gorsuch. This particular tune I first heard played by Chris on the great Wurlitzer organ down at the San Filippo Estate in Barrington Hills, Illinois. Interestingly enough, Chris got this from another wonderful, famous theater organist, the one and only Lynn Larson. Lynn composed this tune back in the 1970s when he was the organist at Organ Stop Pizza in Phoenix, Arizona. Here's the Organ Stop Boogie.
Given us a lot of wonderful hits over the years. This next piece of music is probably the one that she's the best known for. It was written back in 1939 and it is literally known the whole world over. A beautiful piece of music featured in The Wizard of Oz. Here is Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
Thank you.
next piece of music was written in 1944 by British light music composer Eric Coates. Eric Coates had a wonderful career, and he wrote many interesting and descriptive pieces of orchestral light music. This particular piece comes from a suite that he composed. The name of the suite is the Three Elizabeths Suite, and each movement of the suite was dedicated to a monarch with the name Elizabeth. So one movement was dedicated to Queen Elizabeth I, Elizabeth of Tudor. The second movement was dedicated to Queen Elizabeth, the Queen Mother. And this piece that I'd like to share with you was dedicated to, at the time, Princess Elizabeth, who of course is now Her Majesty the Queen Elizabeth II. A wonderful piece of music that will show off a lot of the orchestral color in this instrument. Here is the Youth of Britain March.